are you guys doing today? Okay. So, Bismam Boa Manifesco Dus Adam Lakamen. Today, I'll be giving a sermon on Thanksgiving, specifically the life of Thanksgiving. So, what is Thanksgiving? Thanksgiving means the act of giving thanks. And the question we ask ourselves is, who do we give this thanks to? In Luke chapter 17, verse 15 to 18, Jesus cleansed 10 lepers, but only one came back, and he was a Samaritan. When he returned to Jesus, he threw himself to Jesus' feet and thanked him. Jesus in return asked, "Where are there not 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner?" So here we see that when we give thanks, we are glorifying God, acknowledging his lovingness and kindness to us. And so when we usually give thanks to God, it's usually at like the beginning of the day or the end of the day, or on a holiday or important events. And this is wrong because we should be giving to God, thanks to God always. And this is called living a life of thanksgiving. On account of this, the prayer of thanksgiving precedes all prayers. All church rituals and masses begin with the prayer of thanksgiving. Also, the 7 prayers in the Agbia, either in the morning or at night, we also give thanks in the ablution of the hours. For example, in the first hour, we say, "We thank you, O eternal King, for you have permitted us to pass the night in peace and brought us to the daybreak. We thank him for keeping us safe during the night and giving us a new day in life." The church even begins with the prayer of thanksgiving at funerals. And you can find more examples of this in Pope Shinoda's book, The Life of Thanksgiving. We should also be giving thanks for all things. We call God the beneficent because he does good things. He also makes sure that what comes from people becomes good. In the prayer of thanksgiving from the Agbia, we say, "Let us give thanks to the beneficial and merciful God, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ." That is why children of God are always joyful and thank him for all things. They do not do it as a duty, but from the heart and with all confidence. They are completely confident that God will not allow anything bad to happen to them. For example, in the story of Joseph, his brothers sell him as a slave, which was an evil act, but God changed his evil into good and made Joseph second in command in Egypt. So there are 5 levels of thanksgiving. The first one is giving thanks for miracles. This is giving thanks to God for miracles and gifts. Some people may not give thanks for these miracles because they see it as natural and normal to them, and they don't need to thank God for it. The second one is giving thanks over little stuff. So this is giving thanks to God for a recovery from a flu or a cold. The third is giving thanks for what is hidden. This is giving thanks to God for things unseen and that God has protected us from. And this is God is protecting us from things Satan is trying to harm us with and make us fall. We do not know it or see it, but we need to thank him for protecting us from it. As Pope Shinoda said, "Believe me, if God disclosed the calamities we were exposed to and he cast away from us, if he uncovered this, our whole life will not be enough to thank him." The fourth one is giving thanks for all things. We need to give thanks to God for everything. It is enough that we are already in his care and his children. And the fifth one is giving thanks over tribulation. We need to give thanks to God for the troubles we also endured and not only the gifts we received. We should thank God for every occasion and condition that we experience, whatever happens, and do not allow mishaps to lessen our faith in his protection or lessen our thanks to him. This reunites and lifts up the hearts of his children to God. So in the book Pope Shinoda created, he mentioned 17 things we should give thanks to God for. But since it was a lot, I decided to narrow it down to 6. The first one is giving thanks to God for being born. We have to thank God for he created us and gave us existence. Have we ever thought about how God gave us life, how he was never obliged to create us, or it was possible we could have not been existed? It could have been possible that our mother and fathers could have denied giving us birth, and only our brothers and sisters could have been alive and we would have not been created. The second one is giving thanks to God for the faith we are in. As Christians, we need to give thanks to God for letting us get this perfect faith freely and easily. There are people who want to be and want to have our faith but cannot reach it because they have family, social, and other problems. We have a grace that the atheist people have never attained, and we need to give thanks to God for that. The third one is nature. We need to thank God for the nature around us. If it wasn't for God, we wouldn't be able to live in this beautiful world. The fourth one is health. We need to thank God for the state of health that we are in right now. We don't have cancer. We haven't lost a limb. We aren't paralyzed. We aren't blind. We aren't deaf. We need to give thanks to God for these things. There are people who are unfortunate and have them. We don't value the thing that we have until we lose it. Like the saying goes, you don't know what you have until you lose it. For example, who gives thanks to God for being able to walk on his feet? But if we had a fractured leg, then we realize that walking is something we should thank God for. Therefore, thank God for your good health, as many people desire to be in our position and they cannot. The fifth one is that we need to give thanks to God for still being alive. We need to give thanks to God because life is a gift from God. He can keep it or end it at any time. We are fortunate enough to still be alive while other people are dying. God is giving us the opportunity to do something good and improve our spiritual life. The sixth one is we need to thank God for his loving and kindness. We need to thank him for how many times we have sinned and asked for forgiveness from God, and he still forgives us no matter what we did. How many exams he made us pass and we were not prepared for them. How many times has he solved our problems? How many times has he delivered us out of our troubles? These are reasons why we need to give thanks to God for his loving and kindness. So there are three virtues of thanksgiving. There's actually four, but I decided to put two together and make it three. And these are the three things we need to live a life of thanksgiving. The first one is we need faith and patience. We know God's plan is perfect, even when life circumstances seem unfavorable. We wait on God with a thankful heart, knowing he's in control. We can take an example of what happened to Joseph. He was sold as a slave, and although he accepted that and served honestly and sincerely, a fabricated charge by the wife of the Potiphar resulted in his imprisonment. Time went by when he thought that God had abandoned him. But at the right time, God turned to his trial into good, released him from prison to become the first ruler in Egypt. Therefore, it is a matter of patience and waiting for God, believing he's able to turn evil into good. The second one is we need humility. We need to be humble and give thanks for everything we receive. We should not be proud and think we deserve more than what we have. To live the life of thanksgiving, we need to be humble. For example, if a proud man obtained a senior position, he would perhaps give no thanks to God because he believes he is worthy of a bigger position. If someone praised him, he might have presumed that such praise is not to his level. But the humble feels shy of any word of praise because he who knows himself and wants to receive punishment from God instead. This is because it is better for us to be punished here on earth as it is temporary, while instead of being internally punished. The third thing is that our one and only objective is God. Very often some people have worldly or materially objectives and become sad if they are not reached, and they cannot thank God because of how occupied they are to these objectives. So on a recap of what we have learned, thanksgiving as a lifestyle is not just an action, but a way of life. We should give thanks in all circumstances, even challenges. We need to develop a heart by trusting in God and focusing on his blessings. There's also three spiritual benefits of thanksgiving. It strengthens our faith, brings peace and joy, and aligns us with God's will. The key takeaway from this lesson is that thanksgiving goes beyond words. It's about living with constant appreciation and grace. And if you want to read The Life of Thanksgiving by His Holiness Pope Shenouda III, there's a picture of the book on the screen. Thank you for listening.